Well, it is a scourge of the modern workplace. We're talking about bosses who bully. And if you've had one, you know just how bad it can be. Gary Namie is director of the Workplace Bullying and Trauma Institute, also the author of The Bully at Work, What You Can Do to Stop the Hurt and Reclaim Your Dignity on the Job. Mr. Namie, thanks for being with us this morning.
Thank you, Heidi.
You know, some people may not realize that you say actually 1 in 6 people on the job are bullied.
That's
right. That seems to be a huge number.
It is a huge number, and we call it the silent epidemic. Everyone knows a bully story, either through direct experience and maybe 1 degree of separation. If it wasn't them, then they know somebody who had it happen. But we don't talk about it enough.
How do they get away with it?
Oh, they get promoted. They get promoted to where they're actually immune. They can do this with impunity. It's just all there is. We love aggression, and people climb the ladder, and they do it over everyone else.
That's incredibly frightening. You have come up with 4 types of bullies, though. I want to quickly run through that list. The first one being the snake. Tell us about that.
Oh, Jekyll and Hyde, backstabbing, duplicitous. One who hugs you and loves you, tells you that to your face, but is out to destroy your reputation and the rest of the organization.
Yikes. The screamer?
Screamer.
Seems obvious.
Well, and that's our poster boy or girl. Don't forget, 58% of bullies are women. So it's the Bobby Knight syndrome. It's the yelling, screaming, fist-pounding, vein-bulging maniac. And they're trying to control the emotions of the place and instill fear.
I bet they do it, too. The nitpicker.
Well, the nitpicker is a constant critic. They get you behind closed doors, and they erode your confidence and your competence. You've got a long career, stellar career, and suddenly you get a new boss, and they're going to try and convince you you're stupid. Outrageous as it sounds, but potentially traumatizing.
Oh, I'm sure. And the gatekeeper?
The gatekeeper is the controlling person who messes with your schedule, denies you vacation time, gives you the horrible task assignment. They control you by withholding the things you need to succeed.
Well, when you look at this list, I mean, I'm sure everybody has maybe recognized some of those characteristics in bosses that they've had over the years. But who is it that the bullies are likely to pick on most?
Different than the playground, Heidi. In the playground, it's a vulnerable kid with a Coke bottle glasses. In adulthood, it's a strong, independent person who's technically skilled and refuses to be subservient. And so there's a push and shoving match going on. I must control you, no you won't. And they're very threatened. The bullies are very threatened by those types of individuals. So it's a strong worker, actually.
Okay, and you quickly mentioned women. Women are bullies, too.
Absolutely. Half of all bullying is woman on woman.
All right, so now that we have seen all of this, we recognize that, okay, maybe my boss really is a bully. What do you do? Do you just go to HR? Do you keep a file? Do you keep notes on different, you know, occurrences that have happened? What can
document if you want, but who's going to read the notes? And no, you don't go to HR, I'm sorry to say. You've got to go high up the ladder, 3 steps. Easy to say, incredibly hard to do. Naming it is powerful, and it's a first step to making it legitimate so you don't blame yourself. Call it bullying, call it psychological harassment. Step 2. Get time off from work, and while you're off, what you've got to do is check your legal options, check your health, and start building the case, gather some data for step 3, which is expose the bully, go bully busting. You got to go as high up as you can, not HR, and make the business case the bully's too expensive to keep. And you've got to show the turnover and all the other incidental things that the bully causes in terms of disruption, absenteeism, lost productivity. And if that company doesn't want to listen to you, you get out for your health's sake.
Time to move out. All right. Gary Namie, we certainly appreciate your time this morning.
Thanks
so much.